I'm Jen Soska.
And I'm Sylvia Soska.
And we're the Twisted Twins. And we're on the set of our new movie, See No Evil 2.
Action.
Help!
Nice.
Is that okay with you guys?
We grew up in North Vancouver, Canada. My mom's a huge horror fan. She had this extensive, or still does have this extensive collection of Stephen King novels, and we always saw our mom reading them, but she wouldn't let us read them until we were in about grade 3 or 4. Then we finally convinced her, so we sat there reading them with a thesaurus and a dictionary. And it wasn't until we were 10 that my mother actually finally caved in and let us watch Poltergeist. And she did something after that movie that would forever change the way Jennifer and I looked at film. She explained what we had actually seen. She explained the actors, the script, the directors, and the monster makers, and I thought, oh my gosh, it could be a job to scare people.
We directed for the first time in high school. My sister and I won the first conjoint director's award.
We started with just doing everything ourselves. We maxed out our credit cards to make our first film. Our second film, my parents, they mortgaged their house to be the first investors because everybody was too afraid of the material.
Just in case, let's just have him stand there and bring it in and hit him with it.
Girls aren't really encouraged enough to be writers or directors or producers. They're always told you can be a model, you can be an actor, you can be a singer. I hate to say it, but I didn't have a lot of female role models that directed and did horror when I was growing up. My role models were Robert Rodriguez and Quentin Tarantino. And the most fulfilling thing that we get is so many little girls saying, I want to be the Twisted Twins when I grow up. I totally encourage that. I think there should be more females that are doing what we're doing.
Action!
Having been in this world for so many years, I'd never been directed by a female before. And I never understood it because usually the leads, the heroines, the final girls are women.
I think that horror is a genre that has a lot of empowerment for women in front of and behind the camera. With the final girl character type, it's one of the few genres where females are in the position of power.
We need to do something we can do about it. You're such a prick.
We had the rewrites so that the women were definitely the ones in the position of power.
Hey!
Women, on average, just seem to be more used to suffering and pain. And they're very connected with their emotions. If you do a horror film and you don't emotionally feel for your characters when you kill them, it's a real failure.
You want to be in the audience and you want to feel the knife going through. Otherwise, it's just a cool kill. And I think that the girls aren't into making it just a cool kill. It has to be this whole experience. Bringing a female's perspective into it is really different than what's been done for so many years. And that's why it looks the way that it looks and you care about these characters, because women think about things differently.
Guys.
It's needed to happen for a long time. And they're kind of taking the genre by storm.
They see it more as art as opposed to, okay, this is how we need to do this because we need a scare here, we need a jump here. And they love the genre. Sylvia told me that she used to watch horror movies with her mother when she was a little girl, and she's like, they give me a warm, fuzzy feeling. So they're students of the game.
Jennifer and I are insanely dedicated to the genre, where we watch about 3 horror movies a day.
They have such a love of horror films, and I swear, these girls have seen every single horror movie ever made. They're true fans to the genre, and I think that makes a really big difference when you have actual fans who know what they're doing at the helm of these kinds of shoots.
But I'm also gonna need glass bottles with body parts in it to break on top of them so it looks really nasty.
Embalming jars, and we need one to break with a big, long, stabby shard, yeah?
Yes, one break has to have a long, big glass shard because that's used later on in the fight for one of the stunts.
I'm just staring when I'm all petrified, and then
Sylph will do a lot of the setting up the shots. She's usually with the DP, and I'm usually with the first AD. So I'm about the time, and she's about the art.
If we get this,
the next scene and maybe one before lunch, we're happy. We're just laughing then.
Jen is the how and I'm the why. She always makes sure all the little tiny details are taken care of, and that's so I can immerse myself in the fantasy world that we're creating.
Cut!
Jen is more technical and Sylvia is more on the creative side. And Jen has a deeper voice than Sylvia does. So that's the way I can tell them apart.
I have a birthmark right here that I always draw on darker just so people can tell the difference, and I also have fangs. And I also used to date Jack Daniels, so my voice is deeper than Sylv's.
Jen's a much nicer person. If you're talking to someone who's an insufferable, awkward bitch, that's probably me, and they're like, oops, sorry, Sylv, didn't actually want to talk to you. Jen!
I'm proud to say I could tell them apart day one. I don't know about the rest of the cast, but day one, I had it down.
I remember when I first got the gig, I was chatting with them, and I was a little bit embarrassed to ask him, and I was like, so how do I tell you girls apart?
Action.
And they gave me some hints, and then they're like, as soon as you start to get to know us, you'll be able to tell the differences. And they've done this really good job at the fact that you can trust both of them. No matter who's coming up to you and talking to you, you can just trust that they know what they're doing.
These two are absolutely a team. As long as you can find one of them, you know exactly what both of them want and what they're thinking.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, action, rehearsal.
The best thing about them is there's two of them. So one's always watching the performances and the other one's watching the lighting, the camera angles. They won't miss a beat.
Just no breathing or anything? Just be dead?
It's okay to
breathing at the beginning, but as soon as she gets up, you can just stop breathing.
Okay.
Yep.
I think it's brilliant. I think every director should be cloned and have two of them on set.
This isn't my bathrobe. I don't own a bathrobe.
Oh,
or,
no.
Or pants. This was given to us from wardrobe.
This is for the fans. Making such an ambitious project, you need to have that levity there. You need to be a family. You need to care about everybody. You need to know about their days.
Everyone loves the twins so much. They hug everybody in the morning. They go around, like, it must take them like 3 hours to go around and find everyone and hug them and make them feel special and make them feel like a valued member of this team.
Good morning.
They let everyone know how much they're appreciated. Everyone, from craft service to the PA standing in the hallway locking up.
Good morning, Steve.
Good morning.
If you aren't working in a happy, nurturing environment, you can't really push people to their full extent. He's gonna bleed red from all of his wounds, and then blue's gonna come out, formaldehyde liquid. Oh, sorry, Glenn, I put that on your
shirt. Stuff off my stuff.
Sorry.
We work hard, but we have fun too.
There you go.
Yeah, I gotcha. Whoa, watch out, Glenn.
People turn in better performances, everybody, cast and crew, when they're having fun.
Sorry.
I'm so excited to die and go home.
Boy,
I'm so excited. Oh,
when you watch a movie, you want to have a good time. And if the cast and the crew are having a good time, that energy is reflected onto the screen.
Surprise!
Guys, seriously?
Over the weekends, I'm bored and killing time going, when's it gonna be Monday? I wanna get back to set. I wanna hang out with everybody again.
Go hard, hit me, do it, now!
You know, we've got cast members showing up on their days off just to hang out.
Our sets are always positive. If you're embraced and encouraged and you feel that you're working with people that actually care about what you're making, it makes a world of difference.
Text us, it doesn't matter if it's 4 in the morning, like if you're thinking about something or you have a question about a scene, call us, we want to talk about it with you. I don't think I've ever had that on another shoot where the directors have been so excited to run through the scenes and really create something together. And it makes a really big difference. I think we're going to come out with a fantastic product because we're all invested in this thing.
You have to have people involved in the process, and it has to feel like it's something for them as well.
This has actually been the most rewarding experience of our lives with the most amazing crew. We didn't just make a horror movie, we made a dramatic piece, we made a comedy, we made an action horror movie.
Yeah.
And because we are capable of doing it, it's all because of you guys.
It was the most rewarding experience I've had to date in filmmaking.
It was a real privilege to work with every single one of you guys, and it's the last thing that we're gonna do, so let's beat the shit out of a stunt guy and this guy. Let's see how much shit we can bring.
Thank you.
I just want to work with the twins again. If I could just make movies with them for the rest of my career, I'd be a happy guy.
Yeah, there's...
Help me! Help me!
I think I want to be part of this family. And the twins said, you're stuck with us now, and I think I'm okay with that.
See No Evil 2 is the greatest experience of my life. Seeing the script come to life, it has been such a rewarding process.
Thanks, guys. Have a good one. Was that okay, guys? Yeah, did that work? Was-